Oh, you were waiting for me.
You've finished talking?
Yes, we've come to a decision. My thanks for keeping Meteon company. Emmett Selk and Hithlideus have already retired to their rooms. There is room for you too, if you would follow me.
Something first.
Elpis flowers?
Go on. Feel sad too. You're not alone.
I see Meteon has shared much with you. May we talk a moment?
Hmm.
I do not think it wrong that we live for the star, that we strive to make it a better place. And yet, in carrying out my duties here, there are times when I am plagued by doubt. Do you recall what Hithlidaeus said when we first spoke of my nomination? Death is the privilege of those who have fulfilled their purpose, a choice they embrace of their own free will, and when they depart, it is always beautiful. Perhaps it is, but only for man. Creations that he deems useless are discarded with nary a second thought. Some scarcely born into the world, afforded a handful of breaths before life and potential are abruptly extinguished. We make an effort to spare them the pain, but they sense what awaits. Rage and anguish and cower in fear. And it is not beautiful. Yet no one cares. No one. So fixated are we upon the duty that we do not pause to question the method. Pain and suffering, confusion and despair, writ plain in the eyes of those poor creatures. Yet no one sees. We turn a blind eye and carry on in blissful ignorance. Naught amiss. And always, always the blossoms shine pure and white. A contradiction so blatant I could scream, want to scream. How can you all accept this aberration? And I wonder, am I the aberration for thinking thus? And I am filled with dread. But now I know I'm not alone. Not the only one for whom the flowers weep. Owen asked what you thought as you kneeled beside the Alpis. Or if you only did it at Meteon's insistence. Nevertheless, I thank you. To know that you too have experienced suffering is a comfort. Lest you misunderstand, I derive no pleasure from your pain. It's just the fact that you are still here in spite of your suffering gives me heart. The stars in the heavens, know you what they are? Though it is too far to tell, each glittering light could be a world not unlike Aether's, a world filled with life. So many stars, so many lives. For us, there may be no higher purpose than to live for our world. But what of the other living beings out there? What is it that gives their lives meaning, that drives them day after day after day? To pose that question to our undiscovered cousins, I created beings of dynamis, who can traverse the vast emptiness between the stars. Meteon and her sisters. Aye, sisters. She has a great many of them. And they have already departed on their journey, traveling to one star and then the next in search of life. As one might expect, exploration on such a grand scale is rife with difficulties, and thus far I've naught to show for it. But I have faith that we will make some manner of discovery ere long. And when we do, I should be glad to share our findings with you, in gratitude for your kindness. It's getting rather late. We had best find our beds. It would not do for both of us to be sleep-deprived on the morrow. Come, Meteon. Let's head back.
All right!
Yeah.